In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
The internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Whoa! Good God, y'all!
What is it good for?
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
The internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Whoa! Good God, y'all!
What is it good for?
Absolutely!
Let's get started again.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
The Internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Whoa! Good God, y'all!
What is it good for?
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
The leader in talk radio on the Internet, right here on K98 Talk.
We'll be right back. This is the Liz Harrison Show.
Good afternoon, folks. Thank you for listening to Vigilant Liberty Radio. I'm Liz Harrison. If you're catching this on K98Talk.com, thanks for listening there. It is Thursday, May 14th. I was talking on the Twitter just a moment ago with another Vigilant Liberty person, Alan Bordius, host on Monday and Tuesday nights. He's going to get inked today. I am very afraid. Seriously, I did not even ask what the tattoo was going to be. Because I'm honestly just a wee bit afraid. If you've listened to Alan on the air, you know why. Who knows what he's going to come back with? We'll find out soon enough. But, oddly enough, speaking of tattoos, I did warn the people who follow me on Facebook. You had been warned. I'm going through bustle.com. And that is BUSTLE.com. And really, it's a truly frightening site. It's a wonderful place for me to go to get things to ridicule. Yeah. And one of the stories that I had, ironically enough, picked out before Alan brought up the concept of getting a tattoo, was an article about fat positive tattoos. Yeah, I really am disturbed. It says 11 fat positive tattoos that remind us to celebrate the beauty of every roll and wobble. Okay. I'm not going to comment on some of the side headlines, because you know, you go on these sites and they give you other headlines to look at. Anyway, the first one is a fat pinup girl, which is arguably in the style of the old 40s pinup girl, you know, like with men would have painted on their airplanes and obviously on themselves, and have recently come back in vogue thanks to, well, various tattoo shows. They just did her with bigger curves. Yeah. And, of course, they had to offer one that is actually sitting on a cake and appears to have heart-shaped pasties. Really, folks? Come on now. And here's a good one. A heart-shaped pizza with an arrow through it, and it says, "Live fat, die yum." Really? And then a fat mermaid, Miss Piggy. I guess there would not be. thing about that. And, of course, fat boy and fat girl. Showing the fat boy is showing pizza and hamburger and milkshake. And fat girl is showing, I think, cupcake, chocolate, etc. Yeah. And then, of course, there's one that says, "Being fat means more room for tattoos." And then a tattooed lady. And then somebody just had on rolls of fat, tattooed, "Still beautiful." And then there's pancakes and maple syrup with a naked nymph. Really? And then riots, not diets, with Ursula from The Little Mermaid. I am ambivalent here for multiple reasons. I mean, while I don't want to encourage anyone to engage in fat shaming, these aren't necessarily positive messages either. Yeah. They're basically saying that, you know, it's not necessarily a bad thing to be fat, which of course some studies are showing that to be the case. And then there are situations where it simply isn't the case. And honestly, tattoos are forever, you know. I ponder what happens when any of the people who get these tattoos, what they're going to end up thinking. They're probably going to be jumping for either a cover tat or a laser removal if they ever end up in a situation where they really do end up giving up the fat positive message because they have to remain breathing. You know? Because that does happen too. You have people who end up being hit with the reality that being fat really isn't for them, and they, in order to stay alive, need to lose weight. So my objections are not so much about having a fat positive message out there in general, as long as it's not promoting unhealthy lifestyles and shortening people's lives. There are some people, they are absolutely correct, that are not meant to be thin. But tattoos are a different ballgame, you know. We've all seen it. You see, they actually devote multiple television shows to the concept of, I had the wrong kind of tattoo. And of course, we have Lord knows how many websites that feature tattoo fails. And I would hate to see any of these people end up in that situation simply because they wanted to make a quasi-political statement. Because, yeah, it is, thank you, Nanny Bloomberg and Bill de Blasio and Michelle Obama. This is becoming politicized. Obesity has become politicized. It is no longer an issue of just health. It is an issue of politics, as in how much should the government be involved in determining people's body weight, body mass index, whatever you want to do. So, yeah, I wouldn't necessarily, I will have a link to this on the show page, but I wouldn't necessarily suggest that anybody go to see it. Because it's filed under very, very odd. I mean, and I'll be honest, the tattoos in question are very well done. So at least they didn't have flat-out fails involved here. For the most part, they're well done. Anyway, moving on from there. Let's go to Taco Bell. Mm-hmm. Now, this was just posted 14 hours ago, or thereabouts. NBC Chicago said the management of a new Taco Bell in Wicker Park, in the west side, just applied for a liquor license. Yeah. It would be the first in the 6,500 store chain to do so. And, of course, if one does it, you know that more will seriously consider it. Now, this is a new store design and everything here. They've gotten a whole new design there. And they're basically saying that they want to offer boozy milkshakes, or something like that. Yeah. Yeah, they're going to have a completely new urban restaurant design, whatever that means. I don't want to know. I really don't. But I'm not sure. They're trying to figure out, of course, at Bustle, what they're going to do. So, presumably they're going to be doing something interesting. Who knows? I'm ambivalent only because, you know, teenagers, this is a typical stop. But, let's be honest. I mean, they serve liquor at Chuck E. Cheese. I'd argue that that was just a brilliant move on their part because some parents simply absolutely need a beer or a glass of wine to tolerate being in Chuck E. Cheese. And their prices are too high for anybody to really bother getting drunk, so. And it's not like they have a bar in there either. So, we'll see. We'll see. Let's see if they get their liquor license, and if they do, what do they do with it? You know, this is all filed under pop culture news that usually is off the beaten path for a lot of conservatives for whatever reason. So, after all, who would think, oh wait, west side of Chicago, go and have liquor served in a Taco Bell? That's the only thing that's got me really ambivalent, the location. But hey, what are you going to do? Maybe the move is being made because of other reasons. I don't know what the headaches are to get a liquor license in Chicago. I know that there are big headaches here in Pennsylvania, so I know why they didn't come here. Anyway. Yesterday I brought up the concept of people, Americans in general, not approving of cheating in marriage. You know, that's the one type of sex that remains taboo, is arguably becoming more taboo than it had been previously. Well, Bustle, I guess, must have come across that, because they're coming up with a list of reasons why people go, or at least exploring why people turn in the cheaters. Yeah. Now, while most Americans apparently disapprove of cheating, according to statistics, where Bustle got them, I'm not sure, 30 to 60%, so this is a very wide margin, so I'm guessing that they might have looked at multiple sources. I can hope that, but hey, it's Bustle. According to statistics, roughly 30 to 60% of married people will cheat at some point during their relationship. Of course, trying to pinpoint an exact figure is near impossible, because cheaters often don't want something that many married people see as the ultimate betrayal out there for mass consumption. So yeah, it would be difficult to get a straight answer. Whatever the figure is, new study is showing that most people will report those cheaters. The research team took 487 college students with an average age of 19, 67% of whom were women, and gave them a scenario regarding person A who's been cheated on by person B. The participants were told that it was with person A that they had friendship or connection, and since that was the case, would they inform person A of the infidelity of person B? And they found that 89% would tell. They go on and they put it very confusingly, but the point remains the same. Most people will sit there and tell somebody if they know that their spouse or significant other, person who they are dating, what have you, they're going to tell them. They're going to tell them if They were cheating. Hmm. That's a scary thought, isn't it? I've got more time, so I'm gonna go and look at some other crazy headlines that they've picked up that don't necessarily show up on our radar. Yeah. Giggles the Pig is running for mayor in Michigan, and here's why he deserves your vote. Scary. Scary! Mm-hmm. Although, they might actually be right, but we'll see. It is a real thing. It's actually happening in Flint, Michigan. You can insert snarky comment now because of it being Michael Moore's hometown. But, yeah, someone nominated their pet, so now Giggles the Pig is running for mayor. I'm going to wonder at the whole concept, of course, just alone, that Flint, Michigan allows people to have pigs as pets. But, hey, whatever. Anyway, who is Giggles the Pig running against? Well, the scary thing is the pig could possibly win because, you know what, the other choices are worse. You got either a convicted murderer or a convicted drunk driver. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And as for why this happened, there was a clerical error resulting in an entirely fill-in ballot in the Flint mayoral election. Yeah. And as for how the pig got in there, defense attorney Michael Ewing owns the pig. So, oh dear, yeah. Anyway, as far as Giggles goes, yeah. The pig apparently has been getting in trouble, expressed humility, and owned up to his mistakes following some pretty heavy language in regards to Wantwas Davis, the convicted murderer. Giggles publicly apologized on his Facebook page. In politics, we should be able to disagree and be civil about it, the pig wrote. And I wasn't too civil. Pretty honest, don't you think? The pig is talking better than the humans or something. But he's not the first one. Mm-mm. There's Tuxedo Stan, who ran for office, a cat candidate in Canada. Ran for office in Halifax 3 years ago. Bosco, the dog, mayor. And he ran, and the dog that actually ran and won for mayor of Sunol, California, and now has a statue in his late memory in the city. Clay Henry, the beer-drinking goat. Yep, didn't make that up. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Clay served as mayor of Lajitas, Texas, from 1986 until he died in 1992. So, who knows? Maybe Giggles the Pig is just what Flint, Michigan needs. I'm going to say, you know what? I want to campaign for him. I want to campaign for him because this is filed under... I will never get tired of tweeting to Michael Moore, but your mayor is a pig. That alone will make this priceless. Just that. Seriously, folks, that would be grand. Wouldn't you love to be able to do that? Wouldn't you? Really? I think that's just filed under priceless, you know? That would be absolutely wonderful. Okay. Now, in other news, from the world of pizza, Domino's is making it possible for people to order pizza via Twitter. Yeah. This is thanks to emojis, by the way. As of next week, you can order Domino's by tweeting a pizza emoji. I'm trying to figure out how they're going to do the whole payment deal. But, yeah, I'm trying to see where this is. Okay. Let's see. You can just tweet the pizza emoji to the Domino's account, and the company will answer your wordless cry for help with a pizza delivered right to your door. Okay. I have no idea how this is going to work, the logistics. They're saying easy order and blah, 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 but obviously there's going to be something that you have to do to sign up to do this. I'm going to wait until next week to figure out what it is because, again, I'm still stuck at the bustle.com, which basically means that writing is not necessarily clear. That's the only problem with going there. Lovely, lovely people. Sometimes words are hard. Just saying. They sort of write things out in a weird way. Anyway, at the end, they're saying the ordering system rolls out on May 20th, so prepare your bank accounts accordingly. And if you haven't downloaded the emoji keyboard yet, this is the perfect opportunity. Although, if you don't use emojis by now, you're probably not the type to order pizza through Twitter. I'll be one of those people, thank you. And of course, they're picking on me for not having emojis, and I'm like, I don't care. I got pulled into doing them on my phone, and I don't touch them, so don't bother. Sorry. Don't bother at all. Anyway. I don't think that I can afford to lose any more brain cells, so no more bustle. That's enough for one day, maybe 5 days, or 10. I need a quick jolt of intelligence, so I'm going to go read a UPI. Oh, and before you get all upset, yeah, that's on something that is fairly cerebral from the world of medicine. Yeah. We recall that we've had people, doctors in particular, obviously, warning us against overuse of antibiotics. There is a new study. Yeah. Apparently, it is not just an issue with worrying about antibiotic-resistant strains of disease. No. There is another issue. Especially in infants. So this is a big call out to parents here. Overuse of antibiotics may also be impeding the development of infants, causing them problems down the road as adults. Yeah. They're most commonly prescribed for children, antibiotics in general, but they may be causing changes in infant gut bacteria, which has been connected to allergies, diseases, and obesity. And the findings of the study may lead to changes in the way antibiotics are used with infants. Now, they've been talking about this for some time because they were concerned about diseases like MRSA, etc., the resistant illnesses. But As any mother will tell you, antibiotics also raise havoc in a children's, in their children's system, infant system, beyond any of that. I mean, this is stuff you can see immediately. Like, we understand that when you take antibiotics, you're killing not just bad bacteria, you're killing good bacteria too. Well, now they're saying that killing of the good bacteria is possibly resulting in lifelong problems with immunity, because that is what it boils down to. There are immune issues involved as far as allergies, diseases are concerned. And we've seen all of the commercials talking about probiotics and how the majority of your immune system exists in your gut. So if childhood or infant antibiotics are affecting gut bacteria that and it's having lasting effects, that is not a good thing. Just saying, folks. So this came out of Minneapolis, and it's from the University of Minnesota Department of Computer Science and Engineering and Biotechnology. So basically, they're studying this from the perspective of the intersection between computer science and biology. As a quote goes, diseases related to metabolism and the immune system are increasing dramatically, and in many cases we don't know why. And that's a quote from Dan Knights, a computational biologist from the University of Minnesota. So, previous studies showed links between antibiotic use and unbalanced gut bacteria, and others showed links between unbalanced gut bacteria and adult disease. Over the past year, we synthesized hundreds of studies and found evidence of strong correlations between antibiotic use, changes in gut bacteria, and disease in adulthood. So basically, they didn't conduct a new study. They went and took a whole bunch of existing studies and tried to figure out if there were links between them, and apparently there are. So, in case you're wondering, this is the future of medicine. You're going to have studies that show you one thing, and then you are going to have individuals like Mr. Knights from University of Minnesota go in and use those results to correlate with other studies and figure out the connections between them. So this is filed under major step in the right direction, and look for many more studies like this in the future. Anyway, enough of the science. It is the bottom of the hour, so I will be back after the news.
This is Vigilant Liberty Radio News for Thursday, May 14th. Amtrak train number 188 derailed in Philadelphia en route to New York Tuesday evening, killing 7 people and injuring more than 200, according to federal investigators. While the precise cause of the derailment is still undetermined, authorities say the train was traveling upwards of 100 miles per hour when it entered the curved area of track where the crash took place. The maximum allowed speed in that area is 50 miles per hour. The engineer pulled the train's emergency braking system just after entering the curve, but it only slowed the train slightly before the locomotive and all 7 passenger cars derailed. On Wednesday, rescue workers continued to sift through debris from the crash. Authorities have not yet accounted for everyone on board, and teams have expanded the search area to look for victims. U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry met with Russian President Vladimir Putin in Sochi on Tuesday, hoping to ease tension between the two nations that have developed over the continued crisis in Ukraine. Russian polling group Levada Center reports 59% of Russians see the United States as a threat, up from 47% in 2007. Of those who see the U.S. as a threat, 31% worry about an American invasion and occupation of Russia. A new proposed law in Denmark could be a step toward changing how people bank. In an attempt to end the cycle of boom and bust economies, the proposal would abolish cash and normal bank accounts in favor of government-controlled or centralized banks that could encourage or discourage people to spend money. To encourage spending, the bank would impose a negative interest rate on the money in everyone's account, essentially a tax on savings. And when the economy is booming, the negative interest rate could give way to a tax on transactions. And the Logan County Board of Education in West Virginia is being sued by the mother of a teenager over alleged violation of her son's constitutional right. The suit was filed by Tanya Laherty on behalf of her son, Jared Markham, who was charged with obstructing an officer and disrupting the educational process back in 2013 after he wore a National Rifle Association t-shirt to school and refused to turn it inside out. While the charges were later dismissed, Markham did serve a one-day suspension. The suit seeks $200,000 in compensatory damages and an additional $250,000 in punitive damages. This has been Amy Curtis with your Vigilant Liberty Radio News for Thursday, May 14th.
Hi, I'm Taylor Millard, co-host of The Right War, here on Vigilant Liberty Radio. I'll give you one simple reason why you need to listen to Liz Harrison and me every Wednesday and Thursday night at 11 p.m. Eastern. You never know when I'm going to put my foot in my mouth. Liz, I've had similar situations with you in bed.
Wait,
what? What? That just came out way wrong. That's The Right War, every Wednesdays and Thursdays at 11 p.m. Eastern, here on Vigilant Liberty Radio.
Hi, this is Steve Hamilton, station director at AltCon Radio, and that sultry voice you're listening to is Liz Harrison on The Liz Harrison Show.
I'm back. ISIS. Big problem, you know? Big problem for the U.S., right? Gotta love this one. This is an older story, but I'm laughing about it because it was resurrected on the forums, etc. And I'm bringing it up because we're all arguing somewhat what are we supposed to do about ISIS? Okay. Now, in Lebanon, most Lebanese hash, we're talking about weed here, is produced by Shia, who are sworn enemies of the Islamic State. However, they're selling hash to ISIS. Now, this is important to consider for multiple reasons. Okay? Now, we understand the whole concept that ISIS is, well, nuttier than anything. They're a bunch of radicals. They forbid everybody except apparently themselves. You know, hypocrisy reigns even in ISIS. But apparently they will forbid everyone from smoking, but they're going to engage in using hash. You know, they're supposed to live clean lives. They're not supposed to drink alcohol. Certainly, I would think hash would be off the table, right? And of course, there's the bonus that it's being sold to them by their sworn enemies. So, double dose on the hypocrisy, folks. This is important, and it sort of disturbs me, because this was on the Daily Beast, and I have not heard anybody from, you know, Fox News, the various military individuals out there, the consultants and experts and former members of the military that talk on ISIS. They have not mentioned this recently, and it is very, very important. There are certain things that the leaders of ISIS have engaged in that are contrary with the policies that they want to promote. Now, here in America, we call it hypocrisy. We go and pick on the president over it. We pick on liberals over it. Liberals pick on us about it. It goes on both sides of the aisle, whether you like it or not. You don't want to own up to it when you do it yourself, and you're certainly going to be quick to blame it on the other guy when they do it. So, what does it mean, though, when you're talking about extremists? It becomes a fully different situation if you bother to use it. I mean, we should be littering the areas where ISIS is. We should be just literally spamming. And this is filed under, where are you, Twitter? Facebook, I think, has been relatively clean. I mean, I did come across, inadvertently, an Islamic fundamentalist group where they discuss religion. I'm not sure how far off the deep end they are yet, but seriously, where is Twitter here? I mean, we go and make complaints about the concept of them letting ISIS-affiliated accounts keep on running. They're not quick enough to take them down. How about this one, folks? How about Twitter sitting there and picking up what Jesse Rosenfeld from the Daily Beast and anybody else who comes up with anything like this, the hypocrisy of ISIS? You know what I mean? They should be tweeting about this in Arabic, in Urdu. You get where I'm going here? Yeah. Twitter itself. Why don't they make accounts and do this? It's a good question, folks. Because, you know, theoretically, that would be much easier than having the government create a whole bunch of accounts. I mean, sure, go ahead and ask the government for the content of what to tweet. But why isn't Twitter offering to create a whole bunch of, literally, spam accounts that would just totally hammer the people they know are talking about ISIS with information, you know? Hashtag war, but do it with the guys who arguably caused the creation of it. You know what I mean? Because I wonder how effective they would be. And how effective would they be? It came across my radar yesterday, and I was like, I don't want to talk about this, but then this came up, so I'm thinking, okay, I'll bring it up, but only in passing. Pamela Geller, she showed something that is absolutely horrific. I'm here, women in the United States that complain about people who get upset about them deciding to breastfeed in public. If you do that in ISIS territory, ladies, you're going to get whipped, or you're going to be disfigured. and arguably not be able to feed your infant because they're going to literally rip it off with pincers. Yeah. So, how many young women do you think that the ISIS is going to be able to pull in if we're hammering the social media with information about that and directing it toward the people who are actually talking about ISIS? You know what I mean? It's information, people. It's being truthful. Point out their hypocrisy. Show that they are buying cigarettes. They are buying weed from Shias. They are buying weed from Shia farmers. They are buying weed from Shia farmers by the ton. And that's not being hammered out there as, quote, propaganda. It is truthful propaganda. And we're not hammering it out there for what reason? This is why we lose. This is why we lose. Okay. Enough of that before my blood pressure goes up. I'm going to just go in and go into a safe, happy place and pick on Bill O'Reilly. As I put it in the Facebook post, yeah, Bill O'Reilly is and this is on billboard.com. Bill O'Reilly is blaming the decline of religion in America on hip hop. Yeah, it's all hip-hop's fault. So O'Reilly has taken to the Geraldo Rivera camp, saying that hip-hop is worse than racism for black people. Although, I'm not sure. Jury might still be out on Rivera's contention. But the death of religion by hip-hop? There is no question that people of faith are being marginalized by secular media and pernicious entertainment. Wow, who knew entertainment was pernicious? Big words. The rap industry, for example, often glorifies depraved behavior that sinks into the minds of some young people, the group that is most likely to reject religion. Okay. I'm going to take a leap here, and I'm going to make a really bizarre suggestion here, but we bring up these issues of social policy. We watch as Americans, particularly young Americans, are increasingly for things like gay marriage. And we watch as evangelical institutions rail against that. And you wonder why. Okay. And we're going to go and look here for a second. Okay. Published, I'm going on to Amazon here for a moment. I went on to Amazon and said, as my search, which is yielding more than it did before, but I'm surprised at how little it is doing. But it is increasing. I put Christianity without a church. These were my search terms. Now, at the bottom of this first page, so I'm only sticking with page one here. Okay, excuse me. Compassion without compromise. how the gospel frees us to love our gay friends without losing the truth. Okay, that's the book. And that was published on October 14th of 2014. I'm going to make a guess here. There's probably a heck of a lot more published after that. Okay, I'm going to move back up. Okay, moving back up here, and let's see. God Without Religion, Can It Really Be This Simple? Published October 1st, 2011. Okay, there are more books about that, by the way. Because I said Christianity Without Church. If I went God Without Religion, just like that book title, I have a sneaking suspicion we're going to get more. But I was being nice. Because I was limiting it to Christianity for a reason. I'm going to explain why. Because Bill O'Reilly got upset over Pew Research. And he was saying that, you know, hip-hop is the death of religion. No. Okay. Then, let's go on here. How to Change Your Church Without Killing It. That one dates back to 2000. The Church Without a Name. That dates back to 2004. How to Be a Christian Without Going to Church. The Unofficial Guide to Alternative Forms of Christian Community. That goes back to 2014. There's a reason why I'm pointing out that these go back quite a few years. This is not new. I mean, go back to 2002, and we have Christianity Without God. And then another book with the same title, with a different author, published in 2014. So, not only are they saying that it's possible to have Christianity without a church, they're even talking about not having God. They're trying to shift the paradigm. They're trying to come up with definitions for what they want to believe. And when I say they, I mean the masses of people out there. Young, old, it doesn't really make a difference, although the younger are more likely to search for alternatives. Now, on to the Pew Research Center and the Changing U.S. Religious Landscape. This is the poll, the results that O'Reilly is all upset about, and it ranges from 2007 to 2014. And what he is upset about is that the group of individuals who are unaffiliated has increased by 6.7 to 22.8, placing it in second place behind evangelical Protestants. And that group has suffered a 0.9 drop. Mainline Protestant has suffered a 3.4 drop. Catholics have suffered a 3.1 drop. Okay, math is hard, and I'm gonna fix the math a little bit here, because speaking from relative personal experience and speaking with other individuals who have been in the same boat as me, it is not unfair to sit there and say, okay, we could pretty much ignore the 3.1 drop in Catholics. Because Catholics seem to go, more than any other group, with the all-or-nothing deal. When they leave the Catholic Church, more often than not, they self-identify as agnostic, which is not unaffiliated, by the way, and atheist. There is some give and take in there, but we do have 3.4 plus 0.9% of the evangelical and mainline Protestants in there. So removing the 3.1 from the Catholics isn't completely unreasonable. Or at least partially so. So you add three, and then you add in a 1.2% increase in non-Christian faiths. Okay. Now, that includes, and there's a reason why I'm saying that you got to think about them too, is because it includes Jews, Muslims, Buddhists, Hindus, other world religions, and other faiths. That, and now, Buddhism, above anything else, is a common falling point for people that leave another church. They will go and get involved in Buddhism because of the straight spirituality. Think Zen and the Art of Motorcycle Maintenance. So, this increase of 6.7% in unaffiliated individuals. Pew does not ask them if they believe in a deity, and if so, what deity. So while you bemoan the possibility that we are seeing a radical decrease in the number of Christians because of an increase in unaffiliated individuals, the reality is that there's a good chance a great deal of those people, that increase, are actually people who have been alienated by religion and doctrine, but still have faith, and would still self-identify as Christian if in this study they didn't have to say that they are evangelical Protestant, Catholic, mainline Protestant. You get the idea. They are individuals who are approaching their faith on an individual basis and still may believe in Christian ideals, but don't agree with the churches. There are churches out there, the Presbyterian Church recently went and said, okay, we're going to accept gay marriage. They had a lot of churches leave, but they had a lot of churches stay. I'm not even going to give much credit to the situation where the church, with the churches that left, because I don't think that they've offered information as to whether or not the congregations had actually voted to leave the presbytery. If they did not, then that's just the minister making the decision on the part of the congregation. I have said time and again, and this is not saying that I'm pro-gay marriage or anything else like that. I have said from the very beginning, this is an argument that should not be settled by the government. This is an argument between a group of people and religious leaders. And those religious leaders in that group need to go and hammer that out. The only role the government should be having in this is to make sure that nobody is forced to do something that they believe is wrong. Nobody should be forced to leave their religion at the door. That's all. They should have the right to follow what they choose as far as their faith is concerned. As far as the increase in unaffiliated people in this country, I'm starting to think that maybe the people are starting to disagree on a doctrinal level with the religions that they have been raised in. So they end up leaving, instead of going the route of trying to change the church without killing it. And in the case of Catholics, there is no change. There are no means for Catholics to exert pressure on the hierarchy to make real change in Catholic doctrine. Doesn't happen. So, I would not be surprised if we see even more decreases in the number of Catholics, but that's neither here nor there. So this is something to consider, but sitting there and categorically blaming hip-hop, not so much. There are a lot of other things at play here, and more than just hip-hop. Let's think about just normal, everyday youth rebellion against elder authority. Right there. They see that their authority figures do not necessarily hold the same values they do, or more importantly, are holding on to issues that they honestly don't care about. I mean, I think that there is a certain level of apathy as opposed to activism, especially where gay marriage is concerned. I think that it has gotten to the point where there is a fair amount of people out there that have reached the break point and they don't care. It doesn't matter to them if gay people are permitted to marry because it doesn't affect their tax rate. It doesn't affect whether or not they can put food on their table and keep a roof over their heads. It doesn't matter to them. So rather than coming out against it or anything like that, they sit there and say, fine, let them have what they want, so long as they shut up. Just being honest here, folks, I'm guessing that that is the case, especially where youth are concerned. They don't care. They may have some degree of activism involved, but I think that it is more about apathy than activism. It is more about the idea that I have big school loans. How am I going to pay for them on a McDonald's wage because I can't get a decent job? That's a bigger problem than whether or not Jim can marry John. Just saying. Anyway, it is about that time. So, it is Thursday, big night here on the VLR. 7 to 9, of course, is the Rod Eccles Show at 9 p.m. Eastern. The release of the PolitiNerds. The podcast comes out. That is when you can download it. You can't get it before then. And that is with Jez Shaw and Doug Matakonis. Then at 10 p.m. Eastern, you have Dustin Hoyt, America Our Way. And at 11, There Must Be Pie. Jason Pye will be joining me and Taylor on The Right War, simulcast from FTR Radio, which of course is our lovely, lovely friend across the way. If you love VOR, then you must be loving FTR too. So, hopefully you will join us for some of that programming later on tonight. As for me, I am out of here.
The internet will never be the same. You're listening to K98Talk.com.
Whoa! Good God, y'all!
What is it good for?
Absolutely!
Let's get started again.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break. And at the worst possible time. Call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on warranty. Washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98Talk.com.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break, and at the worst possible time. Call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98Talk.com.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break, and at the worst possible time. Call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The leader in talk radio on the internet, right here on K98Talk.com.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break. And at the worst possible time, call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.